Should you accept that job offer or turn it down? Should you marry that person you're currently dating or not? Should you even be dating now? Or does God want you to wait? Should you move to that new city or country where it seems like there are many more opportunities? These, my friend, and more questions are ones that you will have to answer at some point in your life, no matter who you are. There have been important decisions you have had to make in the past, and there will be more still in the future. How, my friend, do you make these decisions? How do you know the will of God in the major events that will take place in your life? How do you make the right choice? How do you know that what you are choosing is not just what you want, but that it is also what God wants for you? These, my friend, are some of the things we'll be looking at in today's video. If you are struggling with a big decision right now, or you are at a crossroads in your life where you need to know the will of God to make the right choice or to know what to do, then, my friend, today's message is definitely for you. Sometimes, it seems like the will of God is almost impossible to know. It almost seems like God hides His will purposely away from us and enjoys watching us struggle to find it. But is this really true? Is it so difficult to know the will of God? Is it God's will that we should so struggle to know His will, that we should constantly be confused about what He wants us to do in that situation or which path He's leading us at any moment in time? At other times, it seems like it is so difficult to hear the voice of God. Do you, my friend, ever feel like you are in a game of hide and seek with God, like you are trying to find Him and He's constantly hiding Himself away from you? Like you try to hear Him and you strain and wait only for Him to delight in turning you away with nothing? Maybe not. You, my friend, know that your God is loving, He is true and just, He is faithful to His word. So, why do you struggle so much to know His will? Why does it seem as if He is purposely keeping it away from you? Why is it so difficult to know what path to choose sometimes? Which way to go? You, my friend, don't want to be like the man the Bible speaks about who makes a choice confidently only for him to find out at the end of the road that he chose wrongly. You don't want to make that wrong choice. You don't want to go out of God's will or do something that he would not want you to do. You don't want to make a mistake. How do you hear God for sure? How do you know what the Lord is saying to you right here, right now, in this situation? How do you know who you are supposed to marry, or what job offer you are supposed to accept, or where you are supposed to spend the rest of your life, or what your purpose in life is? All these things and more are dependent on being able to figure out what the will of God for your life is at every point and season that it is required. How can you know what His will is? Here are a few things that will help you get clear on what the will of God is for that situation or decision. The first thing you have to realize is that it is God's desire for you to know His will. He wants you to be able to follow Him, and to do that, you will need to know what His will is. To help you understand and hear Him even more easily, He has given you His Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, my friend, is God's own spirit, as much God as the Father is God, which means whatever the Father's will is what the Spirit's will also is. Why is this important? If you think God is purposely trying to make it difficult for you to know His will, you, my friend, are already fighting a losing battle. It starts to feel like a waste of time because you think He doesn't want to reveal His will. But we know clearly from scriptures that it is God's desire for you, my friend, to know His will. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that by testing you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. That, my friend, is in the book of Romans, the 12th chapter, the 2nd verse. Peter shows clearly that it is God's desire for you to be able to discern and know His will. He also shows you a few things that may be keeping you from knowing that will right now. Before we take a look at them, I want you to understand, dear child of God, that the Holy Spirit inside you is the one who communicates God's will to you. The more you understand how He speaks to you and know how to listen to him, which will only come by experience, the easier it will be for you to discern the will of your Father. Whatever else you may be told, my friend, will help you to figure out the will of God. It will only work because through the Holy Spirit's communication and his helping, you are able to figure it out. The second most important thing is to realize that nothing can change God's sovereign will for your life. There are two aspects of God's will: his sovereign will and his will on a situation and case-by-case basis in your life. His sovereign will is his highest desire and purpose for your life. It was God's sovereign will that Jesus should be slain for your sins. No matter what else, nothing could have stopped Jesus from dying on that cross. You can rest in the knowledge that no matter what choices you make, even if you will sometimes make mistakes, nothing can change God's sovereign will for your life. Nothing, my friend, can separate you from his love or make him turn his back on you. Let that give you, my friend, peace and freedom from fear so that you are able to make more decisions. Although you may miss out on some things, when you miss the will of God in certain situations, nothing will take away from what he has already given you and has already blessed you with. To figure out the will of God, you, my friend, must be more interested in his guidance and his direction than you are on what you want the outcome to be. Sometimes, my friend, you are asking God to reveal his will on a particular matter to you or a situation you want him to give you direction on, and you have already decided what you want to do. If the only reason you are asking is just to confirm your choice, you, my friend, may miss God's will for you. This doesn't mean that you should ignore your desires or feelings. Many times, they are a marker as to what God's will is on a matter. He gives you feelings and desires to line up with his will, but it is not always so. As such, you must be committed to finding out what his will is, even though it doesn't turn out to be what you had in mind. You, my friend, must come to the place where you say and you mean, no matter what you want, even if it is something else, I am open to it and I receive it, dear Lord. Only then can you, my friend, really receive his will for you. Another thing that will help you figure out the will of God easier is his word. Whatever, my friend, you may think the will of God is in that situation, it must not contradict what has already been stated in the word. God will not go against his word. He is not a man that he should change his mind. He doesn't say a thing today and then says otherwise tomorrow. For this reason, it is very important that you must check, when possible, what the word of God says about that situation or about the leading that you have, what you think God is saying. The more important the decision, the more important it is to make sure that you think you are hearing from God is in line with the word of God. Not only does the word help you to confirm that what you hear is in agreement with what God has already said, but it helps you to hear God even better. The more of the word of God you fill your mind with and meditate on, the more you will hear God. Your mind, my friend, becomes renewed and you begin to think more like God, which means that you begin to approach situations more like him, which is why Apostle Paul says you will be able to discern the will of God even more. These, my friends, are only a few truths and tools to help you hear God even better. I pray that as you begin to put them into practice, may God give you charity and understanding on what his will is. May he quicken you to understand what his desire is and what to do in those critical situations you find yourself in the name of Jesus. May God, my friend, bless you.